Could you explain a little bit about your campaign, this Against Hate 2011?
Well, it's a very exciting campaign which we are launching today. The goal of this campaign is to get young people engaged into stopping hate. Now, we're not going to revolutionize the world with this, but these are really important baby steps at breaking down barriers. So 2011 Hours Against Hate is what we're calling it. We're hoping that by appealing to people and having them pledge time, that they will walk in another's shoes, so to speak, where a Muslim young person will volunteer at a Jewish clinic, and a Jew will volunteer at a Muslim food pantry, and a Christian will volunteer to help shelter for Baha'i, and for all the day.
Farah, I would like to ask you that how will it be different than interreligious dialogue among different religious leaders? Will it be a step forward? Are you doing something different?
So, you know, what's really exciting about this is that it's all about young people, and it's all about using 21st century statecraft to move things and rally the forces forward. What we've been hearing on the ground from young people is that they have seen an increase of hate language. They're asking us questions about why it's permissible to be able to speak in a hateful way about each other. Now, let me say something very important. Our country very much values freedom of expression. We think it is very important that you have the opportunity to speak out. It is part of our Constitution. It's the fabric of who we are as Americans. But when you get to a place where you are being hateful of the other person, built upon ignorance or built upon incorrect information, you create an environment that is, it's not only negative, but it actually takes away from the opportunity to actually build constructive societies. You are advancing hatred. We want to condemn hate speech. We want to be able to say it is not okay. And in a nonviolent way, you can have these conversations. And what young people are asking us is, how can we contribute to a positive vision for the future? Now, the initiative that Hannah and I are doing is not new to the world. You see collaborative efforts all the time with faith leaders, with student groups, with others who are trying to do this kind of work. It is not one or the other. We are joining forces with a movement that is happening increasingly on college campuses, in community group, in faith work, in a wide variety of ways. But if you go to Facebook right now and you type in 2011 Hours Against Hate, you have an opportunity to pledge your time for someone else. And what we're hoping to do is to create an awareness that more and more people want to contribute to a positive vision for the future. They want to learn about the other. And whether you're someone like me whose mandate is to engage with Muslims around the world, or you're someone like Hannah who is working on issues of combating anti-Semitism, it is important to see this collaboration. We are working hard to make sure that we are listening to what civil society has been saying to both of us in our respective roles and try to do something in a positive forward
future.
You are addressing youth, basically.
Correct.
And there is the people who really use this explosive language. Let's say in America, is environment is quite conducive. For our type of person who raised to that scale, integrated in American society, there are quite a conducive environment for progress. But what about the countries which is outside United States and have continuously hate, newspapers full of hate, language full of hate? How are you going to address that question? Well, outside United
can
States?
Can I say something? Because, you know, GOTV has been doing some very cutting edge work in Pakistan. And when I was there in February of last year, and spent my time in three different cities in Pakistan talking to young people, many of them had very important things to say to our country about various things that were taking place. But issues of pluralism and mutual respect are things that the young generation also talked about. whether or not you can be angry at a different, you know, a foreign policy goal, whether or not you can be angry or misunderstand something, that is a different conversation than the conversation of how you want to build respectful communities. And I think it's important when I think about the percentage of people in Pakistan under the age of 30, a growing number, an active and interested demographic, a demographic, you're talking about countries that are outside of America. Pakistan has a very rich history. It has a very important place on this planet to think about the way in which young Pakistanis can activate themselves to do something for their communities, to put forward the idea of pluralism and mutual respect, can send a very strong message.
The campaign of 2011 Hours Against Hate.
Hate is hate. Hate is hate. It doesn't matter who the audience is. And what we're trying to do is trying to build off of the interest that came out of the OSCE conference when people said, can you do more to rally a forward movement so that we don't see an increase of hate language in the world, that we are abiding by principles of mutual respect, that we're doing more to educate the next generation that they don't have to live the way generations before lived. And in this moment in time, when everybody is connected online or through their cell phones, this is the moment that you can rally and move ideas in a very quick way. So, you know, what we're hoping to do is to build on the collaborative efforts that are happening globally, whether you are in Pakistan or you're in other parts of the world, and find ways that young people are connecting to each other and getting to know what they're doing for each other. And I think that's a very positive message to send.